going on, guys? Welcome back to another episode of Netfish and Chill TV. Today I'm going to be doing another unboxing for you guys. This time it is going to be a Tackle Warehouse unboxing. Let me explain. I ordered a Lucky Tackle box, and with the order they gave me a $5 coupon for Tackle Warehouse, and I use that as an excuse to go buy some for myself at Tackle Warehouse. So, without further ado, let's get started. Today I'm going to be using my Shimano Medium Heavy Action letter opener to open the box, so let's do it. Stalker skirted black, blue, and purple football jig. Now, black, blue, and purple is a unique color. You hear black and blue a lot, but I have not heard of black, blue, and purple, so I thought I'd give it a try. Oh, this is going to be an awesome dirty water jig. There you go, there's a better view of the jig. Love, absolutely love the colors on this thing. This will be great for any dirty water places that I fish. Definitely going to get some good use out of this. I love football jigs. It's definitely very slow and subtle presentation. I love the weed guard on this too. I don't know if you guys can see that very well. Just two little prongs here. Very stiff. I like it. Next up, we have an Outcast Tackle RTX jig. And this is in sunfish color, 1/2 ounce. This is going to be absolutely killer during the pre-spawn time, because as you guys know, the fry, which are the male bass that guard the spawn beds, absolutely hate, and I do mean hate, any other bait fish, especially sunfish and bluegill, who try to harm their eggs. So anything that resembles a sunfish or a bluegill or any other type of forage, they will swat at in an effort to guard their eggs. And as you guys also know, or for those of you who don't know, jigs strobe in the water, so this will give even more of a presentation and more lifelike appearance to the jig. And there you go, there's a good color of it. Good color to it. I love it. It's got a green pumpkin, a little bit of chartreuse, blue and orange, and it also has a rattle. Just a little bit more attraction to it. I really do like these jigs. Next up, we have another RTX jig from Outcast Tackle. This is a 3/8 ounce, and that is in Texas Crawl. I really love the colors on this. I saw this, and I knew I just had to get it. The colors on it are amazing. Let's get that jig. It's kind of got a peanut butter jelly look to it with a little bit of brown in there. And also has a rattle, as you guys can see there. So that's going to give just some extra attraction for bass who are a little bit finicky to take the bait. And I just really love the colors on this. I just absolutely love the colors on this jig. Next up, we have a Collins Grass Stalker. That is a 3/8 ounce black jig. So this is going to be for super dark water, and that's really probably the only time I've been using something like this. You can see that is about as black as can be. And you'll be wondering, why would you want to use this for dark water? Wouldn't you want to use a bright color? Well, it's actually quite the opposite. Dark water, bass are not going to be able to see things very clearly, so any dark colors are going to leave a silhouette in the water, which is where this would come into play. You're going to see a clear silhouette of this. And as I said before, jigs strobe in the water, so you're going to get a strobing black figure that the bass are going to see. Probably going to assume it's a bait fish and come over and hit the jigs. Last but not least, no jig order can be complete without some jig trailers. I really think that you can't really run a jig without them. They help with presentation. They bulk up the bait a little bit, which can be good. Some fish don't really go for the smaller baits. Some fish like bigger presentations. Some fish like smaller presentations. It all depends on where you're fishing at. And I do think trailers are probably the most important thing about a jig. So I got some big bite baits. Chunk craws in black and blue swirl. I think they're pretty sweet looking, and the reason why I got black and blue swirl is because I could put it on black and blue jigs, I could put it on black jigs, just more diverse kind of bait. The reason why I got chunk trailers is because they're not too big and they're not too small. I think that's just the right size. There you go, there's a good view of what they look like. And these are fortified with bite jigs, so I guess this is Big Bites bait, a little secret. It smells like those one cleaning wipes, that the Gojo stuff. I don't know if you guys know what that stuff is. It's for like cleaning, like really hard to get off substances off your hands. It's exactly what it smells like. But anyways, I think it looks really cool. This one's more black. There's some of them in there that are more blue. And you pair it with something like this. So, give you a contrast. Even better, black, blue, and purple. And finally, the last thing in this box, I got another bag of Big Bite baits in crawl orange swirl. So, some more trailers. Get this out for you guys to see. Swirls, so it can match more than just one. I try to do more general colors so that, you know, you don't have like one specific color, like you don't just get the black, or you just don't get the blue, or just green pumpkin, or just a crawl orange. I like to get ones that have multiple colors so that it can go with different baits. Because I have OCD. If stuff doesn't match, I kind of get a little iffy. So I like stuff that matches, and these swirls match just about any jig that you can get, and they come in a whole bunch of different colors. So definitely check out these Big Bite baits. I think the presentation on them is awesome. So that's it for today's episode, guys. I hope you enjoyed this unboxing. Yeah, I didn't make it as long as the last one. I felt like that one that lasted and dragged on forever. And I don't really like making long videos. I have noticed I get more views on the shorter videos. The ones that are short and sweet to the point, so that's why I made this video as short as I possibly could. If you guys have any questions about any of the baits that I got today or where you could get them, you can get them at Tackle Warehouse. Right now they're in the clearance section, so that's why I got these. I buy stuff on clearance. This way I have more money for more lures. So there we go. If you guys have any further questions, feel free to leave them in the comment box below. Thank you guys again for watching. Tight lines, and catch you on the next episode of Net Fish and Chill TV. See you guys.
This is the way he keeps from being hurt.